The situation now involving Jim Cornette and the Dynamic Dudes, and is the Midnight Express not happy with Jim Cornette's involvement with the Dynamic Dudes? Here's the time to play.
You mind not stirring things up?
Hey, before you get started, can I ask you a question? Are there any more of your buddies or pals you want me and Bobby to come out here and save and bail out before you get going here?
Yeah. Hey, why don't you get over it? Why don't you just get over it? You've been out here making us look like idiots for the past couple of weeks. In front of all these people, we've never fought before. If we had words, we did it in the back. That's bull, and you know it.
Let me tell you something. If you'd spend a little more time with me and Bobby to those two little punks, we might have some title shots around here, Jimmy, and you know that.
Hey, I have done 100% for the Midnight Express, and you know it. I've lived, ate, breathed, and slept the Midnight Express for 6 years. I've never slacked up. You know why we ain't got that title shot, and you know just as well we're going to have others. But you won't
let me slack up. Let me tell you something. You've done a lot for us, Jimmy, but me and Bobby have busted our butts for you. We were the World Tag Team Champions, and we're trying to... You're spending too much time on those guys. You're neglecting us, darn it.
Hey, I ain't neglecting nothing. I'll tell you what, it's a personal thing between you and Johnny Ace. Personal, not professional. It don't have nothing to do with business. You'd be the World Tag Team Champions if you spent as much time wrestling as you did chasing girls and laying out on the beach.
Well, at least I chased girls on the beach. Those two goose routes building sandcastles and throwing frisbees on the beach. Now I'm getting sick and tired of you two guys. Out here arguing like a bunch of two old ladies. Let's put us into it now.
But hey, I'll tell you one thing. Hey. You've been with us 3 years. Bobby's been with us since the start. If there's a complaint about Midnight Express business, then he ought to say it. Bobby, what do you think?
Well, Jimmy, I'll tell you, here lately, I don't know what to think. But I tell you, Stan's starting to make a lot of sense to me.
Hey! Awesome! I've been knocked off scaffolds for you guys. I've been beat up and busted open. I've always done my best for you guys. I've never...
Well, I don't know if we got anything settled here or not. There's a problem there, Fez. We'll be back. Flying Brian is coming up next.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing from Malibu, California, Rusty Reynolds. And introducing his opponent, from Cincinnati, Ohio, here comes Flying Brian!
Fans, let's hear comments from this outstanding young athlete about Lex Luger.
Lex, after recent review of the tapes of our two previous altercations, all the bumping, all the flying through the air you've done, Air Pillman has decided to grant you immediate membership into our frequent flyer program. And with that bonus, you're going to get first class, all expense paid, one-way ticket to Philadelphia, Pennsylvania for Halloween Havoc. And Air Pillman isn't going to be flying in on a broomstick, brother. So get ready for a crash landing.
All right, fans, those comments from Flying Brian, no doubt, 1 week from tonight, it's his Super Bowl. It's his time to shine. Just like the Bengals last year went for the big one, they came up a little short. Maybe this year will be their year, but in any event, 1 week from tonight will be the Super Bowl for Flying Brian. Side headlock, Rusty Riddle from Malibu, California, flies a side headlock, only momentarily there. Flying Brian high up in the air, that leapfrog takes him over in the hip lock.
Pillman has just been sensational, beautiful, high-flying dropkick. Riddle out on the floor. I'm sorry, Jim, I'm going to try to get into this. I know I'm standing here stuttering, standing around like an idiot. I don't know.
I'm kind of embarrassed, to be honest with you.
Well, kind of ain't the word for it, okay?
Well, I tell you, I'm sorry. I really am. I wanted to say earlier, let's just get this thing settled and get it behind us and move on, but it doesn't seem like Stan wants to forget whatever's in his past. What is it?
Johnny and Shane asked me to help them out. Otherwise, I'd give them up in a second, but they're nice kids. They shouldn't be penalized because of Stan. Stan has a problem with Johnny. You don't know what it is. I'm not going to tell you what it is because Stan Lane's still a friend of mine, and I can't embarrass him, even though he came out here and embarrassed me.
That shows a lot of class, and we appreciate
that.
No,
it just shows that I don't even feel like talking about it anymore. Let's go on with it.
Well, I'll tell you something. Flying Brian, he doesn't want to talk much either. He wants to wrestle, and 1 week from tonight, it will be Halloween Havoc in Philadelphia. Very special broadcast here for you fans next week here on the Superstation. We are working to be able to bring you some reports from Philadelphia between 6 o'clock and 7 o'clock next week. And we're working on that to get that arranged. A lot of technical things have to go into that. That's what we're going to try to do next week. We've got some big surprises on the program next week, some great matchups. but we hope to have some special reports from Philadelphia between 6 and 7 o'clock next week here on World Championship Wrestling. And we've got some big stuff tomorrow on the main event at 6 on 5. Well, Gordon Soley's going to have some very key interviews, and if anybody can pin people down and really get to the bottom of an interview, it's Gordon Soley, and we'll have him on the main event tomorrow night.
I think Gordon's pinned more people than Ric Flair, maybe in just a slightly different sense. He's been doing it for 30 years, and he's the best.
Yeah.
Gordon Soley on the main event. Flying Brian, he's been doing it for 2 years, and he's amazing for the time he's been in the sport, just exactly how far he's come, and the pinnacle is Saturday.
Fans still to come. We'll be talking to the Steiners, and we'll see them in tag team action here on World Championship Wrestling. We certainly appreciate you allowing us the opportunity to come in your home once again right here on TBS. Great movie coming up a little bit later, right after our program. And so much going on this weekend as we're 7 days away from Halloween Havoc. Tomorrow's program, our last NWA main event prior to Halloween Havoc, should be most interesting. And the Power Hour next week, well, we've got some stuff for you on the Power Hour Friday night that's going to lead right into the big one in Philadelphia.
You know, on the Power Hour, Funk's Grill, we may have to change that segment somewhat to Funk's Grilled if he grabs that electrified cage at the Thunderdome. And Flying Brian, he is electrified. Coursing through his veins is electricity. I keep looking over my shoulder expecting to see Lex Luger. They're going to tie it up again maybe for the fourth week in a row. As long as one of them is in the building, you can never tell what might happen.
Luger just as apt to be out here as not. I hope that Pillman, Sting, and Flair will cut down on their partying between now and next week. I know the Nature Boy has got some big matches coming up. He'll be in Jackson, Mississippi, and Little Rock, Arkansas, Monday and Tuesday. And the Nature Boy tomorrow night, of course, in Chicago. That's his city. Him and Flying Brian and Sting, they tear it down. They paint it.
I tell you what, Flair, he is something else. He can go for a week at a time. And I know Sting, he's going to be keeping up with him. But I got to think this young man right here, Flying Brian, he's going to be in bed. He tried to go over Rusty Riddle, but Riddle slowed down enough. He was able to get the full Nelson. Referee caused the break from being in the rope. I know Flying Brian's going to be in bed at 10 o'clock every night. He's going to be taking his vitamins, and he's going to be training because this is his big chance. Lex Luger, U.S. Heavyweight title, Halloween Havoc.
Here he is on the second top rope, rather, Air Pillman. It explodes with a not a very happy landing for Rusty Riddle.
Ladies and gentlemen, winner of the event, Flying Brian.
We'll talk to the Steiners and see them in action in just a few moments, but look at this.
Every time I see this, I'm amazed. It's like an elephant walking a tightrope on a rubber band, how you can put the weight and a leap on the rope and not break your neck. Flying Brian does it because he's just that way.
The Steiners are coming up next.